we are in the systems and control laboratory, and this actual room belongs to the aerospace guidance, navigation and control group. We are working on aerospace related topics, mostly on autopilot development and the related control, estimation, fall detection problems. One of our main projects nowadays is the so-called FlipAssets H2020 project, in which we are working on multidisciplinary design optimization. In this topic we are working on the intersection in between structural dynamics, aerodynamics and flight controls. So for partners DLR, the German Aerospace Center, and HUN-REN, the French Aerospace Center, and Technical University of Munich, they are working on various aspects of structural dynamics, aerodynamics, and SZTAKI is the key contributor in the control domain. The control domain means theoretical research in aeroservoelastic control methods and also the implementation of these control methods on board the aircraft. So what you see around here are some demonstrators on which we are testing our algorithms. So typically the series of tasks what we are doing, we are implementing in pure theoretical domain or controlled design algorithms, which are mostly based on robust control theory. After that, if we implemented and tested the control design technique, then we apply those to various challenging problems. For example, flutter control or gust load alleviation or maneuver load alleviation system. And if we design a challenging and high performance control system in the MATLAB Simulink environment, after that we usually port these algorithms into hardware. So we developed various tool chains to be able to automatically implement the theoretical control designs into actual software, embedded software code, and to be able to test it without damaging the aircraft, first we implement these algorithms in a so-called hardware-in-the-loop environment. We built up some very sophisticated and high-fidelity hardware-in-the-loop environments in which we are emulating all the sensors and the aircraft dynamics, and couple it with the actual hardware on board the aircraft. And in case we pass all the tests of implementation, then we implement the flight control computers on board smaller aircraft on which we are able to test the algorithm in flight. And when we tested these algorithms on these smaller aircrafts, then we go to the big 7-meter, 65-kilogram aircraft, which is at Munich at the moment, and we flight test all the algorithms there. So what you see here is the so-called flagship aircraft, what we developed together with our consortium partners. And we are simulating the dynamical behavior of the aircraft. We are monitoring all of its key parameters, and we are also implementing and testing the onboard flight control algorithms. So it's a tool chain in which we are rapidly able to iterate different designs, and without implementing it on the actual aircraft, we are able to debug, and because we are working remotely, a few hundred kilometers away from the aircraft itself, it's very important that first we test the last bits of the software and we only send the completed algorithms, not without as few debugging as possible. When we are talking about a control system, then we always have to consider it in its context. So we are also working on the actuators, which are controlling the flight control surfaces, and we are also dealing with the sensors. So we implemented various different sensors which are inside the aircraft wing, and those sensors are measuring the change of the shape of the wing based on which we are doing the control. And this control serves multiple purposes. First of all, it alleviates all the excessive forces. So if, in case we hit a gust, then we reduce the impact on the wing. In case we are maneuvering, then we are trying to reduce the moment and the root bending forces by active control. And when we are reaching certain speed, then the wing is prone to flutter, which is an unstable aeroelastic phenomena. But with active control, we can push the boundaries of flutter, and with all these control methods together, we are able to reduce the aircraft structural weight, and we are able to achieve fuel consumption reduction. So the main goal is to keep the aircraft as safe as it is today, but try to save some onboard equipment, which is excessive weight. And if we reduce the weight of the aircraft and the structure, then we can carry more passengers, or we can have more fuel on board, and we can fly farther.